Hello everyone, welcome to Woman TV. We at Woman TV very strongly believe that there is a hidden heroine in every woman out there. That heroine is the one who empowers you within you and gives you strength to overcome the challenges in your life. We have a similar heroine on our show today, and she is Khushbu Goplani. Let's understand why she is heroine for us and her journey. Hi Khushbu, how are you?
Hi Shweta, I'm very well. How are you?
Very well. So Khushbu, I went through your life story, and one incident in your life really changed everything for you. Right. Would you like to share that with us?
Right. So this happened in the year of 2015. I was living a very healthy and very good lifestyle. But an accident which happened in 2015 in the month of August, I met with a very major bus accident. So I was traveling to my hometown for Rakhi celebration, and I was in the bus. So my bus crashed in a truck and some truck. And so I was one of the survivor in the bus who actually survived rest. The front seaters, 11, were on spot dead. I was a lucky one, but in the initial 1.5 years, I didn't consider myself as lucky. Why? Because I've gone through a lot of, so when I went and when I got to know that, my injuries are really bad, so we were taken, we all passengers were taken to one hospital wherein a doctor just mentioned that, she have got an internal bleeding, let's just cut her leg off. And I was immediately referred to Pune Hospital, and my doctor mentioned, and my, Dr. Nakulsha, he implanted a lot of screws and plate in my leg. And then, the trouble phase of my life, the struggle phase of my life started. I was never bullied at all. I was a national badminton player.
Yes.
For me, resting 1 minute on the bed was like, where have I come? So I never expected that, my life would just take a U-turn right from, playing a badminton and right from, sitting on a bed bug for like 8 months. It was a very difficult time. Then I picked up, my MBA. I think I thought that, sitting and, sitting at home was not an option that I always wanted to. Why? Because a lot of my relatives used to come at my place and, used to give my mom a very cold shoulder, that they used to say that, your daughter's career has been shattered. She's good for nothing now. You should get, I don't know that who would marry her that way. So these are comments I have heard it from my
suddenly
relatives.
Suddenly very judgmental.
Yes, that's a very bad phase of one phase of the society which keeps on coming and giving you a shoulder. It's not a help, but it's a sympathy what they give us. So I thought sitting over here is not an option, and would just not, it is not a good idea to sit at home. Then I went for my MBA. Yes, my troubles again didn't stop over there. Why? Because I was bullied. I was said langdi ghodi. I was said, is it your accident leg? Oh, I thought you are a polio tick. So yes, I have still taken those comments. And then I wanted to, I didn't said to them over that point of time that I'm hurt. But yes, those comments actually made me very strong. So sitting was not an option. Then I picked up my MBA. I did my MBA from Mumbai, and then I was placed. And yes,
now you're a work woman.
Now I'm a working woman. I'm working with WNS into an international sales. So things have still not stopped. I live with a scar on my leg, and I flaunt it very nicely. Why? Because I feel that, scars are given to some very important person. Everyone doesn't have,
have scars and still look so beautiful.
Yes. Yeah.
Wow.
So that's my story.
And for that phase when you were differently able for some time, I'm sure it wasn't easy. What was most difficult, and how did you overcome that?
Certainly, I still limp, 10%, and still it's not difficult. Coming back and rewinding myself into that phase, yes, I was a different abled person. I was actually limping. When I was going through that rough phase, the phase was really bad. I used to cry. I used to cry I used to sit in the corner. I used to feel that, why am I alive? But yes, everything has its own reason. I feel that this accident have made me a complete different person. I no more now care, and I no more live my life to impress someone. I am here to impress myself. I am here, I mean, I am. I have taken a vote for a certain motto, and this is what I'm just thinking that, what motto I'm here for. So I feel that, everyone should realize that, for what you are born for, and just live your life, happily. Because sitting in one corner crying every day is not an option. It shouldn't be an option, I should say.
Wow, very nice.
Thank you.
And being a woman, especially, were there any specific challenges for you to come back to the work life, sustain there, and grow?
So yes, I have a very big scar on my leg. I still flaunt it. I think 2 years back, I used to always put a knee band on my leg, and I used to tell that, hey, I have a ligament tear, I don't have this scar. I used to hide it. Then, coming every day with a 10% of limp in the office, and when people specifically look at you that, oh, she's little bit limping, and when people keeps on barging at you, what happened to your leg? What happened to your leg? Yes, it's a major, I mean, that is one thing that I am every day going through. But yes, I know that, I know that I'm more capable of doing something else rather than, concentrating on this. So yeah, so that is what I feel. Yes, it's a very difficult phase for a woman, and especially when you're a woman, because not after this accident, not only this, I've gone through, I'm getting now other more things, in my other more side effects of the medicine which I've taken, right? Because it was my woman body, and medication, a very strong medication. So there are a lot more things again which has been rewinding in my body, but again, I have to go through. I don't complain as a woman. I feel actually, looking my scar also, I feel a very beautiful, woman which is there in me.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and everyone should know that.
So, Khushbu, what's your long-term vision for yourself?
So my long-term vision for now is, as you know, is just to tell the society and just tell loudly to the world, what. Don't judge people. Don't judge people by their appearances. Don't judge people by the way they work. Don't judge people the way they talk. Everyone have their own battles in life, and everyone is born with those battles. So just don't judge people around. This life is
Absolutely.
beautiful. The world is beautiful. You just need an acceptance that, okay, you know what? I have this thing, and I have to overcome with this thing. Crying shouldn't be an option. Sitting idle shouldn't be an option. You should do something. You are born, you have taken a birth in this world because of some motive, So I feel that, every woman out there, should do something. And I'm sure you should realize it, and you should figure it out what you're good at something. And once you click that, you know what, I'm good at something this, start doing it from tomorrow or from today itself, I would say.
Wow, nice. And all the women watching you who are going through difficult phases of their life, so many challenges, some are differently abled, some are just trying to cope with their own illnesses. What is your special message for them?
So it is gonna be little offending, but I would say you have to fight your own battles. No one, yes, people would sympathy you, people would empathy you, people are out there who would comment. Just keep that aside and just realize that you have to fight your own battles. No one is gonna, people can support you in your battles, But yes, you have to win the race by yourself. No one is going to support you in your battles. That is what I just want to give the message. Be strong, be positive, be lively, be keep smiling and spread your smile to the world.
Thank you. So that was Khushbu with us, who taught us very rightly that scars can be beautiful too. Thank you. Stay tuned with Woman TV.